Welcome to part three of this series on the best free PowerPoint templates you can download on the web today. Let's go ahead and look at template number 7, the Playful Pitch Deck by 24 Slides. And this is another example of a very pretty set of slides created here in PowerPoint. I'll go to the slide sorter view and you can see there are 10 pre-built slide layouts. Let me just zoom out a bit more. The second, third, and fourth are just examples for where to like, share, and find this presentation template and to use their services. Otherwise, you have the first layout here along with another 9 that are examples of slides that you can use in your own presentation. Keep in mind that this presentation uses the TWSEN MT for titles as a font, and it uses Rockwell for all other text. So make sure that you have those on your computer so that you can display the text correctly here for this template. This template is, again, not what I would describe very much as a template, but rather a set of pre-built elegant slides. And I really like the look and feel of this template. I like the dotted background. I like the consistency of the look. You can see throughout the template, we have this graphical design element that sort of looks like a picture frame that carries throughout the presentation. We have it at the bottom here. I like these little illustrations of people. I think they're quite modern and stylish. And I also like the slight shadow that we have on a lot of these elements here in the normal view. One thing to keep in mind about this template, again, funny, you know, using this word template is a little tricky, but basically these layouts are all designed on almost bare bones slide master. So that means that the only elements that you can actually edit are in the slide master view, and these are just a few: the background and some of these graphical elements that basically exist on the background. You'll notice that the slide master, the parent slide, is designed just like your default presentation. So they've done nothing really super special with the slide master other than add a background element or two here. And so what that means is when you go and make changes to your title, if you go to reset, nothing will happen because this layout doesn't actually have a title. It says title only, but it is just a default layout that has no title. And so that means that you're stuck sort of having to readjust things manually yourself, and that things are going to jump from slide to slide. And you know, it's going to be a little bit difficult to make this look consistent and perfect and polished the way that you would like it to be normally. Another thing to point out about this template that might be a little bit tricky is that because of this design element here, there isn't a lot of room for your title. So if you wanted your title to go and be longer than this, so we'll just add something, title is longer, you know, you would have to adjust this yourself manually. You would hold the shift key to keep it straight, and you could shrink this down so that the title fit a bit longer. But again, this doesn't give you a whole lot of room. And because the font is so big, if you were to go down to 2 lines, it would extend over the content. This wouldn't look very nice. So that's just something to keep in mind about this template. Again, the way to use this template, the best way to use this template really, is to just go with the way it is. So if you're happy with the way this template looks and you can just fit in your content here, you know, I would use this template as is. If you're going to copy and paste it to other presentations, it may start to do funny formatting things. So again, this is one of those situations where these are very nice slides to use as they are, but if you're going to be looking for something that is more of a template where you can actually choose layouts and have things stay consistent, this may not be the template for you. One final thing about this template is there are also no picture placeholders. So if you want to add any pictures, or if you deleted this, again, because it's not built on the slide master and there are no placeholders, none of this would reset. So you have to insert and add your pictures manually yourself. So if you want to use this template, I recommend it only be used for anyone who is already fairly advanced in PowerPoint and knows how to use PowerPoint fairly proficiently so that you can adjust and tweak any of the elements here so that it fits nicely in your presentation. And finally, one last thing about this template, the colors have been added in manually. So let's just see if we change this. You can notice the colors here are correct. So the theme colors are indeed here, but for some reason, these shapes were not built using these actual colors. So when you go to change the color palette, nothing happens because the colors were not applied to all of these shapes. So for the ones where it does, you'll notice these changed and this changed. Some of these changed, but this one didn't. So this template was built sort of with a medium amount of attention to detail, I would say. You will see that some things change, other things don't. So that's just something to keep in mind If you wanted to change the color scheme, you would have to do that manually one by one with a lot of these shapes here in the normal view. But again, a very pretty set of slides. And if you wanted to use this for inspiration for your own slides, I think this is a great example of something that is cohesive and elegant and fairly minimalist that you can use in your own presentations. And if your content just fits in perfectly, then go ahead, by all means, use this template in your own presentations. That is the Playful Pitch Deck by 24 Slides. Free PowerPoint template number 8. Circle Diagrams Presentation Template by 24 Slides. Once again here, we have a template that is more actually a collection of slides than it is a template. If I go to slide sort of view here, we have 10 layouts. These three are just instructions about how to work with 24 slides, but the rest of these are examples of circle diagrams that you can use and copy and paste into your presentation. So this is less designed to be one whole presentation because it's really just a whole bunch of circle diagrams, but these are great to use as samples or examples for inspiration. They're great to use if you have flow processes and if you want to display visually the exchange of goods and services or the steps in a process or even the life cycle of a product. So these are great examples that you can use. Now, the thing to keep in mind is that once again, it's not really a template. The layouts aren't really built here in depth to be created as an actual template itself. The only time that we have an actual layout is for this one here because we have a picture. So if I were to move this mask and delete this picture, we get the placeholder again here for pictures where you could go ahead and insert your own picture and then you'd want to send it to the back and then you can hit reset and normally, and looks like this was built in the normal view. So this actually you'd have to manually place it back to where it was. So there you would be able to change the image, and that is the only layout that really is built to be an actual template, a templification of this slide. So all of these essentially are just built basically on a title only layout, and so that means that they're all built here in the normal view. Now these are not smart arts, so these are actually just shapes that have been built directly here, and so if you were to increase or decrease one of these, you would have to adjust everything accordingly. So for example, if you had one fewer of these, you'd have to go in and delete it. And then what you'd have to do is you'd have to take this whole diagram and you'd have to adjust it. And that means that you'd have to adjust this and this, and you have to adjust the icon. These have been grouped this way, so you'd have to ungroup them. You'd have to be a little bit meticulous yourself and knowledgeable about how PowerPoint works to be able to readjust everything so that it fits perfectly with whatever content it is you have. So in this situation, again, you'd have to delete one of these and then you'd have to redistribute the rest of these across. So this is a great example of types of graphics that you can use if your content fits. So if you had four elements, I would use this one versus using this one because this one has 5, and that will be more difficult to manipulate unless you're very, very familiar with PowerPoint. Same in this situation. It's just a lot harder if you have to change any of the elements within this circle diagram. This template is built with the Sego UE font, so make sure that you have that on your computer, and it also has Calibri. So just so you know, that is the font that is displayed here in case it's looking different on your computer. This is a great set of slides to use as inspiration for your own slides in your own presentations, keeping in mind that most of these use fairly small font size, which means that this kind of template is probably best for a presentation that you are creating as a PDF or that you're printing or that you're emailing, because the content is going to be hard to read from a distance if you're doing a large live presentation. Again, you can adjust the fonts and rearrange things on your own accordingly based on the content that you have. So that is the circle diagram PowerPoint template from 24 Slides. Next up in our free PowerPoint templates, we have template number 9, the Basset Presentation Template by SlidesCarnival. This is a beautiful PowerPoint template with 25 pre-designed layouts that you can see here in the slide sort of view. These all have a similar element that carries through with a sliver of a picture here on the left in different dimensions, and we also have a sort of chunky orange and variation of orange icon here that appears on many of the layouts. We also have some maps along with a couple big data slides, along with a UI series as well here for placing anything in an iPhone, iPad, or computer screen. And we also have a few icons that we can use here at the very end of the presentation. So this is a very nice template if you want to create a presentation that has sort of big concepts, that is more of a live presentation where you don't need to display a huge amount of content because the font is quite large. Speaking of fonts, this template uses the Barlow fonts. You're going to want to make sure that you download that font in order to view this presentation correctly if you don't see it on your computer. Also, this template is available in a Google Slides version. So if you're using Google Slides, you can absolutely download this in that version. A couple things to note about this template is that most of the images here are inserted in the background. So if I go to Format Background, the background actually is a picture, which means that I cannot edit it. So the only way to change this background is to either insert my own picture, or you can simply change it to a solid fill to automatic, and that will make it, oh, that's interesting, solid fill. You know what? It's because the template here has the background formatted the way with a picture here. So that is a problem. You can either reformat it here to be a solid fill, right? So that it works for all the slides to just be white, or you can go slide by slide. And what you can do is format it to a solid fill and then pick a color, or you can actually insert your own picture here to change it yourself. That is a way to easily change the picture here, whether you're doing it on a slide-by-slide basis or if you are doing it in the Slide Master view so you can change it all yourself. Another thing to note is that the template is built basically correctly in the Slide Master here. So we have the layouts here that are set correctly. The only thing that is a little bit different is the pictures. This is different from other templates that we've talked about already. The pictures are in the Slide Master view slide background, along with the slide background of some of these custom layouts. So that is just something to keep in mind, but this is also a very lovely template that you can use in your own presentations, especially for big concept slides or large live presentations where you need to deliver punchy content that doesn't need to be very rich and in-depth. Free PowerPoint template number 10, the Cymbeline presentation template by SlidesCarnival. This is another great example of a sleek, modern, and fairly simple bare bones template that you can find for free online. If I go to the slide sort of view, you'll see that it includes 25 pre-designed slide layouts. They all come in 16:9 widescreen size, and there is also a Google Slides version if you are using that format for your presentations. What I love about this template is the ripple effect echoed throughout the entire presentation in different variations, which I think is very elegant and nicely done. I also like the grayscale effect, which keeps this presentation template looking fairly modern and sleek, and it also allows for any pops of color that you may want to include, particularly if you have slides with pictures in them. This picture is fairly muted, but if you were to throw in a picture with a lot of color or pop, it would stand out really nicely off of the rest of the grayscale, just like this one stands out because it's a lot brighter than everything else in this template. The other nice thing about this template is it includes some icons that you can use, some little graphical elements, along with some pictures that you're welcome to use for your own presentations. Because this template is fairly minimalist, I think it's suitable for a lot of different types of presentations and industries. However, it is fairly large in font sizes, which means that you will probably want to use this for a deck that is not super data or content rich and relatively top level sort of content for your presentation. One thing to keep in mind is a lot of the images, including the one on this slide and on slide number one, I believe, are actually inside of the background. So if the background here is a picture fill, same for here. So there's no way to actually edit this image, whereas on this one, you can make changes to this image, right? So that means that if you want to change the background, you're going to have to go into the background area and adjust the picture here yourself, or you're going to have to insert an image on top of this, but then you'll lose some of the graphical elements that you have here on top of this layout. And if I go to the Slide Master view, you'll note that we have shapes. So unfortunately, if you want to insert a picture on top of this and have these lines come through, you're going to have to insert it here in the Slide Master view so that these carry over on top of the picture. Otherwise, you can copy this element and paste it back in here, and then paste your image underneath so that it still populates. So that's just something to keep in mind, some of the things that you will encounter if you are trying to adjust this template to suit the content that you have ready for your own presentation. The font is Poppins along with Poppins Lite. So if you don't have those fonts on your computer, you may want to download them in order to see the content the way it's designed to be used here in the regular view of PowerPoint. One final thing to note about this template is the color palette was not set up correctly here in this template. So that means that if you were to go to the design tab and change the color scheme to something different, let's just say green and yellow, nothing would adjust because everything was done manually. And again, this is in black and white and grayscale, but you know, this should normally adjust slightly, but it does not at all because the colors were not set up correctly. So if you wanted to change any of these colors, you would have to do so manually. So that is the Cymbeline presentation template by SlidesCarnival. And that wraps up this third part of the series on the best free PowerPoint templates on the web. In the next video, I'll show you the next best ones, starting with a cheerful Olivia template. So stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like, thumbs up down below, leave a comment, and make sure to subscribe to our channel with the notification turned on to find out when we release our next awesome PowerPoint tutorial. Thanks, and I'll see you at happy hour.